Hey guys, it's Kathleen, and I have got another Thrift With Me video. Even though it's December, believe it or not, garage sales are not dead yet in Alabama. However, today's weather is super sucky and it is pouring down rain, so hooray. And after I go thrifting, I get to march in a parade, rain or shine, so fabulous. If you're new to my channel and you like thrifting content, please consider subscribing. You are at the right place. Okay, so I have got two yard sales on the agenda for today. One of them is an indoor yard sale and the other one did not specify. So I have a feeling it's going to be gone when I pull up, but we're going to give it a shot anyway, especially because it was yesterday as well. And yesterday was not raining. So I think they're probably going to be like, yeah, forget this and peace out. But we'll drive by and give it a shot because, you know, yard sale prices beat Goodwill prices every day of the week.
burgers.
We bundle price it all at the end.
Okay.
Like that thing. That thing's so great, you've got to get it.
Nobody uses any of this.
Whoops.
Probably put some, like, you could put them on a Christmas tree or something.
I know.
Like,
I'm not gonna put on a stupid tree.
Maybe that little kid with a bird that wanted a bird outside. He wanted a bird. You could sell him that bird. It's just a bird. He doesn't care what it looks like.
He wants a bird? Where?
The little boy wants a bird that's on there.
I'll give him one of these.
Oh, here's a peacock.
I'll give him one of these.
He just wants a bird.
I want these birds for myself. They're sold to me.
Okay, guys, I am back with the thrift haul portion. And so this estate sale was a huge disappointment. It was one of those estate sales where they were charging eBay prices for everything. And I would even make the argument above eBay prices in some cases. I really went because I was hoping to score one of those Pico aluminum Christmas trees that Shell Bell has picked up a couple of times and done really well with. They sell for about $600 to $700. But I knew as soon as I got there 45 minutes after it started and there was still a line out the door because they had crammed everything into two different rooms and it was a small house to begin with. And they were only letting in about 15 people at a time. So I waited online probably about a half an hour to 40 minutes, which that should have told me something. And then, you know how you go to estate sales and you see a lot of the same people and you know who's a reseller and who's a collector. And so I saw one guy that I see at all the estate sales and he is definitely a reseller and he came out empty handed. So I'm like, oh, darn it. And then another person came out and we're like, eBay prices, you're not gonna find anything if you're a unless you're a collector and you don't mind paying up for things. So I went anyway because, you know, sometimes you can find things that are just laying around that for whatever reason get overlooked. I didn't find too many of those. A lot of the things that I went for were either gone or so astronomically priced that I was like, forget it. I went looking for Rugrats. They had Rugrats new in the box and all three of those were gone. I was also looking for, besides the aforementioned Christmas tree, I was looking for Playmobil toys. I do really well with those and he had a bunch of them that were new and in the box, but the prices were crazy. And then he had this box and you probably saw it in the footage of me rooting through this box of animals. And so when I did a quick comp search, the color in animals do really well from Playmobil. They do really well on eBay. So I'm like, all right, I'll buy a few of these because it said $3. So I found a couple of packages that had like three animals each, but only one pen in the package. So I'm like, oh, surely he's not meaning to break these up. It must be $3 for the package. I'll definitely give it a stab, see how well they do. I get up there to pay. He's like, no, it's $3 each. That's $9 a package. I'm like, oh, well, F that. I am definitely not paying $3 an animal and I've only got one pen. That's just stupid. So I put it back. That might have been a mistake. Maybe it was something that would have sold really well, but I just wasn't really feeling it. So I did pick up another baseball mitt that I swore I would never pick up again. But I knew that Rawlings was good. Rawlings was the one that I sold the last time really quickly. This one is a 13 inch, which you really can't read that there. And it's in really, really good condition. You know, when I was checking out with him, he goes, the guy from the estate sale, he's like, you know, you can buy one of these for $75. I'm like, I'm not buying one brand new. I'm buying a used one. You've got to price it accordingly. But I think he charged me about $5 for this. For everything that I'm going to show you, he charged me $45. Really, he charged me $50. But I ended up only paying $45 because I had $45 in cash with me. And there was an upcharge to use your debit card. And I said to him, look, I'm going to walk away or you can take my $45. So he took my $45. I don't usually play hardball, but I knew he was getting way more of my money than I had anticipated giving him. Okay, so maybe I paid $5 for that. I grabbed one of these just because it's new and in the package and Christmas. Probably this was a mistake. They don't really seem to sell very well at all. I was hoping to make around $10 on this, thinking it was going to be a quick flip, easy to photograph, easy to store, all the things. We shall see. I thought this was worth it. I am always going through this wrapping stuff, this plastic wrap stuff. So to get this big of a roll of this for only a couple of bucks, that was worth it to me. Then I also picked up, and I'm not going to bother dragging it out to show you, but I got a huge bag full of paper products. And I know that's super gross. I don't plan on eating off of them because I do plan on using them in my classroom because I use them with my kids to do building projects. It's a team building thing that we do. I give them all a bunch of random items and they have to build something and who can build the biggest one that can support a bouncy ball. So I did get all of that and that was probably worth probably $5 easily. It was a huge bag. I picked up this trilogy. They're all in really good condition. Lee Grossman's The Magicians. I like picking up books, as you know, and I have sold off a lot of my books recently, so I felt like I could allow myself to pick up another trilogy, especially because, I'm not going to lie, I may actually read this over Christmas break and then sell it. But these are probably going to go right around the $15 to $20 mark. I grabbed this because it's a vintage game and it has all of its pieces. The only problem is because it's an old vintage game, the color forms aren't sticking so well to the matted cards. They keep on falling off. I'll show you what I mean. Dadgummit, there's an ear gone. I have every single piece, but they're not sticking to the thing, but they are all there. So I'm figuring I can probably get about $18 or $20 for this, but the real gem, the thing I paid up for, is this Fontanini nativity scene. It did not come with the box, but it came with its little placard and its little, whatever this thing is, brochure. And so I paid $30 for it. It's a little mini one. But the whole reason that I grabbed it was because I always watch, you know, Kayla, the homeschooling picker, is my absolute favorite. I fangirl so hard on her channel. And I get so many ideas from her, and she always has a lot of luck moving Fontanini nativity sets. So I figured, you know what, even if worst case scenario, it doesn't sell, I don't make any money back, then that's okay because I like a nice nativity scene. So I would happily display this in my home. In fact, my plan was to display it until it sold. Well, guess what? It sold. This actually ended up being a better pickup than I had even anticipated because, oh shoot, I lost baby Jesus. I lost baby Jesus. Well, he's somewhere here. That's going to be problematic since he sold. Hope I can find him. So in with all of the parts that went to the this nativity scene, there was also a baby Jesus. And he was in really good condition, but he's to a different scale than them. So there's a teeny tiny baby Jesus that goes with this one. I'm not saying this very well, but the way Fontanini nativity scenes go is they are all to a certain scale. So this is a 5-inch scale. That doesn't mean this has to be 5 inches. What that means is that the tallest figure in the set is 5 inches. And so that's why they call it to 5-inch scale. So this, the tallest figure, is a wise man, and he is only 2.5 inches. So this whole set is 2.5-inch scale. So every single piece is here with this, and then I sold this separately. Both of these items sold, baby Jesus and the nativity scene. Baby Jesus sold for $18, and then the nativity scene sold for $65. So I more than made back my money. So that was definitely a good venture. I'm a little bummed, to be honest with you, that I'm not going to be able to display it in my house for Christmas, but I will take that because I made my money back and then some. So another thing about the Fontanini that I didn't know is that there's Fontanini, then there's Depose, D-E-P-O-S-E, and then some of them have a spider symbol, and there's no way you guys are going to be able to see this, I don't think. But there's like a little spider symbol up there, and that made this more valuable. To be honest with you, I'm not entirely sure if the plain Fontanini is the more valuable or if it is the Depose. If you know, please let me know in the comments, because that's something I definitely would need to know. Oh, I found Jesus. Woohoo! Okay, that is a relief. So, see, he goes, he just nestles in there, and all of his paint and everything is in such great condition. So I am honestly not surprised that he sold that fast. Okay guys, that's everything for this thrift with me. As always, hit the subscribe button if you like what you see, and I will catch you next time. Bye guys.